Sarvitabhut versus Pokonova. First game, Sarvitabhut to serve level.
Good start there for Pokonova.
This is the type of shot that makes you sit back in your seat and go, well, now, if this is what it's going to be like, I think Sutasini is going to change upper placement a bit throughout. And the first shot she does, but still, Pokonova pulls it right back out and puts the power, pace, and placement on. I mean, that's everything. Look how comfortable that backhand looked
for
her.
Very good, yeah, absolutely.
Good forehand flick here, Sutasini up over the table.
Yeah, Sutasini is certainly one of the top paddlers in this region, Southeast Asia. Fourth at the women's singles in the 2010 Youth Olympics, where people really sat up and took notice. And then, of course, qualified to represent Thailand at the Olympics, as Adam mentioned. Made history for Thailand, which reached the round of 16 in Tokyo. First ever Thai player who reached that round after.
4-2.
Good rally.
4-3.
A little bit flatter shot here. So Wetabut looking for that big opening attack. Maybe I should say big finishing attack, really. Rally already open, trying to put a little extra pace on it.
She was constantly in attack, wasn't she, Sutasini?
It's so tough to win points like this when you have to push yourself to play flatter shots than usual. These are good spins, net recovery here, but punch, I mean, it was her third punch that missed. She made two flat shots very well.
6-4.
Now the head-to-head, the one time they did play, it was a little over 4 years ago at the Croatia Open of 2017, and it was 4-1 for Pokonova.
7-4.
Well, 3-point lead at the moment, Pokonova. That's exactly what she would have wanted, Pokonova. Worked to a tee.
Same amount of advantages and disadvantages.
It's a superb backhand from Sutasini. Who's 1.67, Pokonova is 1.8 meters tall. Just took the edge.
9-5.
It's funny, the point before it was Sawetabut giving some acknowledgement for the edge of her racket, but here the edge of the table. Pokonova moves back into the table. By the end of that point, she was just a bit closer than the last few shots before.
9-6.
Good push right off the bounce. Heavy underspin from Sawetabhut.
It's another good rally.
7-9.
One that ends in the tie's favor.
Good work to move in here, catch it early. She's been moving around the last 2 points. She's managed to keep her sort of positioning right near the table and push Pokonova back behind. Even though she has wingspan and can cover the ground, she's going to be much less threatening from there.
10-8.
Now game points for Pokonova. hard back at each other. And 11-8, Polkanova.
Love, one.
Great backhand, dismissive.
Now this is the spot you want to aim when you're playing a taller player, someone a little bit bigger, right on that elbow. That's where the bigger sweet spot is for you to find a hole, that crossover point between the forehand and the backhand.
Three, low.
Different tune out here right now. Vocalizing a bit, not dropping a point just yet.
Yeah, very good start for Sutasini Suwetabut. Races love to a four love lead.
What'd you call her? Oh, yes, you're right. She does race to a 4-point lead. Beautiful shot. Flat hit, killed on the line.
Unlucky. Good first shot before that.
Yeah, from way behind the table to make that counter. So at the boot, the problem is there's just so much freedom here for Polkanova to block where she wants. Good pressure to the backhand, creates the opening. Smart play right off the bounce with that backhand.
4-2. Five, two.
Yep, restoring that 3-point lead.
Good aggression here. I feel like she's coming out a bit more charged up, trying to stay close and make the first shot count. You can see it in that three, backhand, the way she leans forward, tries to catch it early. Says, if I can get one spinny and a little bit slower from Polkanova, I'm going to try to come in quickly. See her body weight forward there? Just trying to stay close to catch the top of the ball.
3-6.
Good long push here as well.
Six, four.
Feel like we've had a bunch of interesting score lines so far. The last match was really a lot to handle in terms of drama for the faint of heart. And here, Sutasini knowing.
Seven,
back
four.
To 3 points in front, Sutasini.
It's good timing here. The Thai player right on top of the bounce. Saweta.
What a way to return that. Brilliant.
It's not the first time we've seen her get it outside of that wingspan, the wide wingspan of Sofia Polkanova.
Nine, five.
Playing well, Sutasini Suwetabut, and she's got game points now.
Six, ten.
Clipping the net along the way for Polkanova.
Seven,
two, game points saved.
No timeout called yet for the Thai players. Sutasini Suwetabut, leading lady.
Let's 7-10. Ten,
three
eight.
In a row for Polkanova. So she does 11, wrap up eight. This second game. Sutasini Sawetabut, and she takes it.
Love one. One, oh.
There's that sweet spot, the middle, right down the elbow's path.
That's where she wants to be aiming for, right?
Generally, I mean, when Sofia Polkanova's in position, that's going to be the one easy target. And I put easy in quotes there because, as you can see, Polkanova covers the elbow quite well. She's solid. This is a big part of the game. I mean, long before these players become true professionals, they learn how to transition forehand to backhand as quickly and seamlessly as possible.
2-0.
A big part of that is actually balance, which is quite tough to learn later in life. But it's a massive advantage, regaining that balance, making sure that you can transition quickly and recover.
2-3.
Now, as I mentioned, the winner here plays Wang Manyu. Sofia Polkanova has never taken a game off of Wang Manyu, and Sutasini has never played Wang Manyu.
Five,
moves three clear of her opponent now, Polkanova.
Two, six.
Good power from the big Austrian.
Seven.
5 points now, that gap. Looking good here in this third game, Polkanova. She's trying to change up her serve there. Sutasini Sawetabut with the backhand.
Good placement. She's targeted that middle. You could see Polkanova just reaching out in front, deciding which side of the racket to play.
Wonderful counterpunching there. Great work.
Yeah, and that last finishing forehand, as soon as she got that good counterpunch in, she knew that she could take the big drive. Take a look here. One more punch from the middle. That's the one that sets it up. Just a snap reaction, not a lot of time to change.
4-8.
She's done well on that serve. Tried it twice now, and she's got points off them. Fantastic rally.
Yeah, this is absolutely spectacular. The speed, the reaction time, the quick adjustments made by Sawetabut, and Polkanova keeps coming back with one more shot. The flick there to open it up, inside out forehand. A lot of work. Two backhands there. The second one was completely on the forehand side. I mean, she had two in a row from the forehand side of her body with her backhand.
10-5.
Polkanova now with 5 game points.
So clean, so fresh and so clean, that third ball attack.
Six.
She needs a lot more of those, Sawetabut.
I think the facial expression said just the same. It's a long road ahead, but one breath at a time, one point at a time. We can do this.
Polkanova takes game three. She's 2-1 up now.
That's, for anyone to beat Duhoy Kim, really is impressive.
Eight.
Love. Went deep with that push, didn't she?
You know, the boxing analogy is coming back up because I feel like when she spins one, as soon as she follows up with the aggression, you can hear the extra effort put into it, the grunt.
Too low.
It's just become a little bit loud, hasn't it?
Yeah, every point becomes that much more crucial when it's potentially your final game in the event. Now both of them are going to be fighting every point with a little bit more focus. I think this is one thing that makes a champion. Again, when things get tense, the crucial moments, deciding factors.
1-3.
They're just cramping up a space a little bit on that backhand.
Nice time to go parallel. And again, we see the tactics to get very specific to make that first opening attack count.
And
interestingly enough, in this, there's a difference between the backhand and the forehand. Unless she feeds a parallel into the backhand like this, but she's already moving well, right? She's covered on the forehand. It's going to test Polkanova to go very wide, uncomfortably wide, if she's a step behind the table.
Five, two.
Secure with the spin on this one. Ball comes a little bit long, and that's an opening attack opportunity that was not missed. I mean, the placement there, just barely off the edge, almost comes down for a second bounce. Very clean, keen receive there.
Good little run of points here for Polkanova to narrow that gap.
Can see how far she's favoring the backhand, moving over to that forehand side of the table, Saweta Boot, for that aggressive receive. Now that's not so common. In the women's game, we don't see quite as much the Chiquita receive. There will be times, but she just knows that she can generate more pace on the backhand for the short serves that Polkanova is giving.
Right off that far corner, the edge. Polkanova has drawn level.
You can see why they'd connect.
6-7.
It's a nice recovery here. Saweta Boot able to block while backing up, but then regaining control. That's a bit of an escape. From a positioning standpoint, Polkanova controlled the table in that rally.
Off that serve. Nice and quick.
And good kick on it, too. A bit of side and topspin to make it jump off the second bounce, which is what makes it come up into the edge of the racket.
Eight, seven.
Important game, of course, for this one for Sutasini Saweta Boot. Just in front here. Has to win it to stay in this match.
Another one.
Edge.
Living on the edge. Aerosmith over here on the Austrian side.
Yeah, she doesn't want to miss a thing here.
Yeah, you can see that sweet emotion.
Go! 9-8.
Well, let's see if this love will elevate her game.
And that gives her 2 match points.
They're as pumped as can be. This is major in such a huge event.
Saved one there, Sutasini Sawatabut. What a way to win this. Oh, I'm sorry, but then I'm going to celebrate. Fair enough.
Hey, this is life. I mean, you've got to be... I'm actually impressed that she apologized first. She just won a major match to get to the quarterfinals at the first ever Singapore Smash.